Dear WET friends, welcome to our channel youtube.com Dr. WET. I am getting an overwhelming response by my previous videos. Many person has subscribed my videos. Now subscription reached to 650 subscribers. Thank you all for giving support to this channel. I request you all to subscribe it and to send to as many as possible so that our veterinary officers can get the information. With this, we are starting a new section on differential diagnosis, especially for field veterinary practitioners and clinicians. The topic is vomiting in dog, part 1. In this, we'll discuss definition, motion sickness, vomiting related parts, regurgitation, dysphagia, false vomiting, etiology of vomiting, and the pathophysiology of the vomiting. Now, you know that in a dispensary, especially dog practitioners, know that 80 to 90% cases in the hospital is of medicine case, of which 15 to 20% with a complaint of vomiting. So I thought to make a video on this differential diagnosis for the practitioners in the field. I will come with more such differential diagnosis video in future. Friends, you know vomiting, but exact definition you may not be knowing. So here I am describing the definition. It is the reflex action, forceful expulsion of content of the stomach, and sometime expulsion of proximal part of small intestine through the mouth by vigorous, spasmic, involuntary contractions of diaphragm and abdominal and visceral muscles. So vomiting is not a disease, but it is a symptoms of many diseases. We will see the extensive list. Vomiting is a reflex action. Reflex action requires certain stimulus. Without stimulus, reflex action will not occur. It is a forceful expulsion of the content of the stomach by vigorous involuntary contractions of diaphragm, abdominal, and visceral muscles. By synonym, it is also known as motion sickness. When really motion sickness occurs, in motion sickness, vomiting is there. Now let us see what is motion sickness. Motion sickness results in nausea, excessive drooling of saliva, vomiting, and occasionally signs of yawning. Yawning is an involuntary opening of mouth widely and inhale deeply air into the tiredness and due to the boredom. This is yawning. At the same time, motion sickness is also showing whine. Whine is making a long complaining cry or sound by a dog, and shows the sign of uneasiness or diarrhea. So motion sickness commonly accompanied by vomiting. Motion sickness is usually seen during travel by land, sea or air, and these signs usually disappear when the motion of vehicle ceases. So because of the motion, traveling, and there is omission or nausea sensation, it is named as motion sickness. Vomiting required a differentiation from regurgitation, dysphagia, difficulty of swallowing, and a false vomiting, projectile vomiting. Because when the owner brings animal to the hospital, he complains only vomiting. He will not differentiate regurgitation, dysphagia, or projectile vomiting. So clinician is required to differentiate these things. Because we have to solely rely on the history. And in the history, the owner will inform that there is vomiting. Now we see what is regurgitation. Regurgitation is a passive, without effort or muscular contraction, passing food or liquid from the esophagus and or stomach through the mouth. So it is an action like a vomiting. But here, regurgitation is passive. Vomiting is active. In vomiting, there are spasmic contraction, muscle contraction. In regurgitation, it is not there. In both vomiting and regurgitation, there is passing of food material from either esophagus or say stomach. That is regurgitation. Vomiting also require differentiation from dysphagia. Dysphagia is active but ineffective muscular contraction, similar to retching and vomiting, representing a dysfunctional movement of food into GI tract but not out of GIT. Dysphagia also means difficulty of swelling, means it takes more time and effort to move food from mouth to the stomach. So here dysphagia, actually vomiting is not there, but animal makes action just like vomiting. Frequent nausea will be there. Another is false vomiting. False vomiting, other name is projectile vomiting, is food projected passively from stomach through the mouth due to overfilling of stomach. If animal has taken more food, there is dilatation of stomach. Stomach has a capacity to dilate. But when threshold increases, there is contraction of muscle, and without any effort, passively, food will come out through mouth or by gravitation. So when excess food or excess pressure, excess accumulation of gas, excess accumulation of food or any material in the stomach leads to projectile vomiting. Here, the symptoms of vomiting are lacking. That's why it is called as false vomiting. After definition, now we are moving to etiology, etiological classification. It is classified etiological into three: central etiology, peripheral etiology, and emotional etiology. Central etiology, it is due to stimulation of vomiting center. In short, it is called as CRTZ. CRTZ. Certain drugs, example aspirin, phenylbutazone, certain toxemic condition, uremia due to nephritis and hepatitis, stimulate a vomiting center and there is a vomition. One is, other is the peripheral. Here, there is irritation of the mucosa of gastrointestinal tract, gastritis, gastric dilatation, foreign body and stomach, dilatation of the some portion of intestine. These also stimulate vomiting center from periphery. That's why it is a peripheral etiology. The third portion is emotional, where there is stimulation of higher center, either due to fear, tension, or due to motion. There is a vomiting. Motion sickness is one of the part of this. In motion sickness, one thing, motion is there. Second thing, in motion sickness, fear is also there. And that's why there is a vomition. Classification of vomiting based on frequency of vomition. It is two: transient vomiting, a temporary, and persistent vomiting, frequent vomiting for a long time. Transient vomiting is generally due to abnormal quality of food, either decomposed or moldy food when there is fungi growth, acute gastroenteritis, and food poisoning. Here the vomiting is temporary. Persistent vomiting is caused by esophageal diseases, either obstruction of esophagus or stenosis of esophagus, disease of stomach, foreign body in stomach, neoplasm on the wall of the stomach, ulcer in the wall of stomach, pyloric stenosis, uremia. This causes a long time vomiting, persistent vomiting. Now coming to the more technical part, pathophysiology. The vomiting center of medulla is stimulated by one or more of the following four ways. One way is by vagus and a sympathetic nerve from peripheral organs such as gastrointestinal tract, pancreas, heart, liver, urogenital tract, peritoneum, etc. Thus, the disease of these organs leads to stimulation of vomiting center and there is vomition. Another way is chemoreceptor trigger zone. It is called as CRTZ. This CRTZ zone is in the medulla. That also stimulates the vomiting center. Third, cerebral cortex and limbic system. The cerebral cortex, limbic system, when they are affected, they are diseased, certain disease of the brain, they also stimulate vomiting center. Vestibulous apparatus of inner ear is directly connected to the vomiting center and there is vomition. When we see the motion sickness, one is the motion, and during motion, you know, the vestibular apparatus is active because the function of vestibular apparatus is balancing. If this is disturbed, vestibular apparatus, it has a direct connection to the vomiting center And so also there is vomition in motion sickness. In motion sickness, the vomiting is also due to fear. The vomition in motion sickness is also due to excitation. Animal feels that what is going to happen, where they are taking me. So there is stress factor also. Motion is a stress factor also. And thus, the vomiting center responds to nervous stimuli, humoral stimulus, and chemical stimulus that we have seen by these four ways. Causes of activation of vomiting reflex. There are big list of causes, many causes. I told you that vomiting is not a disease. It is a symptom of many diseases. The clinician is required to give a precise diagnosis for correct treatment. We will see one by one. There is big list, but here I have reduced it, which are commonly occurring in field. Otherwise, list is very big. It is beyond the scope of this video to include all causes. So here, which are of practical significance and importance are included here. Stimulation from vestibular system of ear. Motion sickness, fear of vehicle, and that fear will remain even vehicle is not moving. And even if the vehicle is not moving, the animal feel nausea or maybe vomiting and other fear and tension. The another group, increase intracranial pressure and neurologic diseases also causes vomiting. Distension of duodenum, intestine due to obstruction, gas or paresis, ileus, that also lead to vomiting. Distension of colon, generally due to constipation, that also lead to vomition. Many times we are also feeling when there is constipation, there is vomiting. When there is constipation, one thing is directly going stimulus to the CRTSZ and vomiting center. Second is that due to constipation, the food material remain in intestine for more time. When more time remaining, the protein content get putrefied. And due to putrefaction of the protein, there is release of toxin, amines and phenols. And this toxin, amines and phenols cause stimulation of the vomiting center and there is vomition. Very important cause, inflammation, stomach, gastritis, inflammation of liver, hepatitis, nephritis, pancreatitis also causes vomiting. Here the important cause for a clinician is gastritis. Clinician get many cases at the clinics. Blood-borne toxins, exogenous chemotherapeutics, drugs, piperazine, certain antibiotics, pesticides, food allergy, endogenous uremia, we have already talked about hepatitis and nephritis. In that also there is uremia. Septicemia, many septicemic diseases are there, metabolic diseases and electrolyte imbalances also causes vomiting. There are many infection also causes vomiting, but two important here are: one is the Helicobacter pylori that causes gastritis, acidity or ulcer in the stomach and intestine. Important parasite Spirosulca lupi that causes nodule and bleeding in the stomach and in the esophageal wall. Frequently the clinician has observed, and there is complaint also, that the dog eating grass, and after eating grass the dog vomits. This is a complaint received. So here the justification is this: when there is indigestion, the dog's tempted to eat grass and it become a habit that when it's grass and there is vomition, an animal feel little bit easiness, uneasiness to easiness. When there is intestinal parasites, worms, there is irritation in the GI tract, then also the dog has a temptation to eat grass. Some unknown nutritional deficiency also causes dog to eat grass, including need for fiber. When the fiber content of the food is less, then also the dog eats grass. Sometimes there is instinctive behavior, the behavior of them. There is deliberate attempt to induce vomiting, and that becomes a habit. There is instinct to throw up as a form of relief, and when animal doing certain action, eating grass, vomiting, animal feel relief, then it become a habit and animal eats grass and vomit. Dog often eat their own vomit also. Vomit it, eat it. Again, it is also a habit observed. This is a frequent complaint made by owner to the clinician. Dear friend, etiology is an extensive list. I have listed only few that is commonly occurring and complaint by the owner and diagnosis by clinician at the clinics. You have observed Dr. Wait video, requested to share to as many veterinarians as possible. We have started a new section, differential diagnosis for veterinary clinicians. I will come with more videos. I am getting an overwhelming response for you all. Requested to subscribe this video to promote and to support this channel so that I will come out with more and more videos. Thank you very much for observing this video.